Starborn. Remember, to be a star, you have to shine your own light, follow your own path, and not be afraid of the darkness, because that's when stars shine brightest. And we are going to be talking about a lot of new light, because if you've been looking at our website, starborninstitute.org, you would already know that the title of tonight's show is Enlightenment. And that is because this show is covering the wonderful solar eclipse on Sunday that we are having at 8 degrees of Pisces. And there will be four planets in Pisces: the Sun, the new moon, Mercury, and Neptune, the ruler of the sign. And all four of these planets are conjuncting each other, and that compounds their power. So since Pisces rules that 12th house of hidden enemies and things behind the scenes and all areas of confinement, it simply means with so much light in Pisces on Sunday that it will be absolutely impossible to hide anything anymore. And that is good, because enlightenment means that you're going to learn something that you didn't know before. And it can be that there can be some sort of revelation about secrets that had been kept behind the scenes, or an imposter could be exposed, or it can simply be that hidden enemies sort of come out into the light, and shadowy details can now be clearly seen by people because there's so much clarifying light in Pisces. So if you have been trying to hide anything, too bad. I think somebody's going to find out your secret right now. And with that enlightenment right now that we can get from this wonderful solar eclipse, there can be a new beginning that is generated from that. And that is because there are four planets in Pisces, but right ahead of Pisces, there are three other planets in Aries. So there are seven planets only in these two constellations, and that is 70% of all the planets in the heavens. So they are related. If Pisces rules things behind the scenes and there's a lot of light there, that can bring us some sort of enlightenment or truth that can finally come out, and that can help generate a new beginning, because Venus, Uranus, and Mars are all in Aries, the sign of new beginnings, and they are trining Saturn in Sagittarius. And right now, or on Sunday, the thing that we need to watch out for is that Uranus, which is a malefic planet and rules instability or volatility or sudden surprising change and freedom and rebellion, is at 22 degrees, and so is Mars. Both of these malefic planets are at the same degree. They're in perfect alignment. Mars is the stronger because it rules Aries, and they are trining the third malefic planet, Saturn, which is in Sagittarius. So if there was a new beginning that could involve a little bit of evil or a lot of aggression or some strange sudden attack that came out of nowhere, that is possible as well. But we would see who was doing that, because there's so much light in Pisces right behind the sign of Aries. So hidden knowledge that comes out right now can help us all understand the truth a little bit better. And because Pisces not only rules hidden enemies and areas of confinement like hospitals and prisons and jails and sanitariums, but it also rules creativity and dreams and dance and photography and the oil and gas business and the pharmaceutical companies, it simply means that there is a lot of different ways that we could heal from the truth. All of the water signs rule healing. And so Pisces rules the kind of healing that comes from admitting the truth or not being in denial about anything anymore. And above all, Pisces does rule charity and forgiveness. And so this is a wonderful time for you to examine whatever it is you've been in denial about, or whatever you have been sort of keeping to yourself, hidden in your heart, and really take a look at that, because this is going to be a solar eclipse that will help us admit our past mistakes and heal from them and endure the kind of justice that may be needed to correct them so that we can go on and make a new start. And that is really important because there aren't any bad aspects to this solar eclipse except one. And it is that Saturn in Sagittarius, which is trining the planets in Aries, remember, is squaring the Sun, New Moon, Mercury, and Neptune in Pisces. And Saturn is called the taskmaster. It means that you have to sort of obey the rules and regulations. So even if you wanted to make a dream come true right now, or if you feel that it's your turn to step into the spotlight and be a star, you will still have to work hard, and you will have to follow strict rules and regulations, and you will have to accept delay. Then that is because Saturn is the planet of delay. So there would be challenges if you are going to go ahead and admit something and get over it and go ahead and make a new beginning, but you could do that. That's the only harsh aspect to the solar eclipse right now. So if you wanted to make a dream come true, boy, this is the time to get started on it. Because the problem is that there are the Saturn, which is challenging the solar eclipse, is trining those three planets in Aries, Venus, Uranus, and Mars. And because of that, and because the fire signs are very, very action-oriented, it simply means that this is a time when there could be a possible attack that would sort of come out of nowhere, or it could be a time when you would suddenly be very surprised, even shocked, by something. And it could be something that was hidden, or it could be the revelation of some sort of truth that you didn't have any idea about at all. But if there is a sudden attack, then you or I or whoever is attacked would have to use speed and technology in order to successfully overcome or surmount an attack or defend yourself against that. And that is because the speed would come certainly from Mars in Aries, and the technology would come from Uranus in Aries. So if you have to go on the attack for one reason or another, or if you're on the defense because of an attack, be sure and use speed and technology in order to succeed or survive. And that is a possibility. So the solar eclipse itself is wonderful because it represents a sort of a second chance at something. But it's a second chance that's going to have delay and challenges involved, and it will require that you have to admit the truth about something, and it can be a past mistake, and you have to sort of get over that. So what it all boils down to is that this enlightenment can actually, when you do receive enlightenment one way or the other, or you learn the truth or you admit the truth about something, it can free you from any past problems. And so enlightenment is going to free you from being a prisoner of the past. And that is why the enlightenment is going to be so good for you. So this is not a time to keep denying the truth about anything. This is the time to turn around and face it and endure its consequences so that you can be free from any problems from your past. And that is why at the end of the day, when you do get enlightenment in one way or another, it will simply mean that you should listen to the call of the future right now. Because it is the future that is calling you, and that doesn't have much to do with your past. That's why this solar eclipse means that we need to sort of get over our past in one way or another, and it could be by forgiving and not quite forgetting. In other words, it's better to learn from your mistakes. But this is a time when we can all do that. Okay, what does this mean to all 12 of the sun signs? Well, Aries, for you, there can certainly be some enlightenment going on behind the scenes, and you really couldn't hide anything if you tried right now, Aries, because the three planets in your sign, Uranus, Mars, and Venus are trining Saturn in Sagittarius, so you can be certainly very active, very proactive right now, either in wanting to make a new beginning or wanting to get something underway and sort of do it all your way real quickly. Well, I think you could succeed at that, Aries. But right behind your sun sign is the solar eclipse. And there are even more planets there. The sun, moon, Mercury, and Neptune are all behind your sun sign. And that means there is so much light in the background of your life, Aries, that if you were wanting to be in denial about anything, or you were wanting to hide the truth, or you were having a few secrets behind the scenes, those are going to come out. And that might be the reason why you might want to make a speedy new beginning. But I think you can do that. And so that is something that you might want to try. And it would mean that you would be leaving somebody very nice behind. And that's the way it goes, because Jupiter in Libra is opposing the three planets in your sign, and Pluto in Capricorn is squaring them. You might have a good reason to sort of go ahead and do something real quickly. And I think that you would be successful, so you might want to give that a try. Okay, what does it mean to a Taurus? Well, Taurus, an unusual thing is happening today and is happening on the day of the solar eclipse, and it is that there are no planets in any of the fixed signs. And there are four fixed signs, yours, Taurus, and Leo, Scorpio, and Aquarius, and there are no planets there at all. And so that simply means that in a very serious way, nothing is challenging you at the moment, Taurus. But that doesn't mean that your life is going to remain calm at this point. And that is because there are way too many planets right behind your sun sign. So you're very busy behind the scenes. And it's either you that's planning on making a new start, perhaps based on the revelation, some sort of revelation about things going on behind the scenes that you may not have known about. Once you do learn about them or you are enlightened, that may trigger some sort of speedy response on your part, and you could be initiating a new beginning, or somebody else is, and you could be very surprised at who it is and what they want to do. And that is because the planet of surprise, Uranus, is in Aries behind your sun sign, along with Mars and Venus, your own ruler. And behind that are four more planets in Pisces. So there are seven planets right behind your sun sign, Taurus. Oh, and so I'm sure you are very busy. And if you aren't at the moment, you will be, because there's just way too much activity going on behind the scenes. And so you could get surprised, even unpleasantly surprised. But I think that there is nothing seriously stopping you from solving a problem or calmly reacting to some sort of change that is occurring behind the scenes in your life. I think that you will be able to handle it, because you're not going to run into any real stiff resistance, but you probably are going to be very surprised about something, Taurus, and I think you'll have to look deep in your heart and search for the truth. Okay, what does it mean to a Gemini? Well, Gemini, this is a time when you need to be very, very cautious and careful. And so does Virgo. And the reason why is that there are actually five planets in mutable signs in harsh aspect to your sun sign and to the Virgo sun. And so the solar eclipse on Sunday in Pisces means that the sun, moon, Mercury, and Neptune are all squaring your sun, and Saturn in Sagittarius is opposing your sun sign. That's why you need to be careful, particularly since one of the planets in Pisces is Mercury, your own ruler. And what I think you should be careful about is believing people. In fact, try not to believe everything you hear right now, Gemini, because some of it could be a falsehood, or it could involve some sort of cover-up. It might be that you learn about hidden enemies, but it might be because they're on the attack or they want to make a swift move right now. actually, once they go into action, that may not hurt you too badly, but the deceptions and the omissions and the lies and the cover-ups, that is what can really hurt you. So you can't afford to believe everything that people are telling you right now. And instead, I think that you really need to put people to the test and ask for facts and figures and have them independently checked by others before you believe them, Gemini. Because this is a time with Saturn opposing your sun sign and trined by all those planets in Aries that people with old grudges to settle could feel emboldened right now, and they could sort of really go on the attack, and it may catch you by surprise. But remember, those planets in Aries are sextiling your sun. It's the planets in Pisces that are causing the problem. They are squaring your sun. So don't believe anything that you hear unless it can be independently verified right now, Gemini. And if you do need to seek legal counsel, you can get it because Jupiter in Libra is trining your sun, but Jupiter is the only retrograde planet right now. Some legal matter would have to be redone in some way before it could be of benefit to you. Okay, what does it mean to a Cancer? Well, Cancer, this solar eclipse is going to be wonderful for you. And that is because there are the Sun, Moon, Mercury, and Neptune in Pisces all trining your Sun. And that means you are going to benefit from enlightenment, Cancer. You're going to benefit from finding out the truth, which cannot be hidden any longer. And so you may get your eyes opened by the truth. And then you'll have to ask yourself what you're going to do about it. I think in the end, since Pisces does rule charity and forgiveness, you may be in the mood to really understand somebody who's done something wrong and try to help them out. You have a very charitable heart, and you could be nurturing other people as well. So it's good that you can benefit from enlightenment right now, because the three planets in Aries are squaring your sun harshly, Jupiter in Libra is squaring your sun, and Pluto in Capricorn is opposing your sun. You still face many challenges, Cancer, but you are definitely going to get help behind the scenes right now, either because there's so much clarifying light in Pisces that the truth really does come out, and when it does, it really will help you. And at the very least, you will see who is crooked or who has been lying to you, and that will help you decide what to do as well. Okay, what does it mean to a Leo? Well, Leo, this is a time when you can benefit from the fact that there are no planets in any of the fixed signs, which is great. And the solar eclipse in Pisces is 150 degrees away from your sun or in conjunct. So you may not be worrying yourself too much about what's going on behind the scenes, because there are four planets trining your sun sign, and the three in Aries and Saturn in Sagittarius. And so upon enlightenment by others, or the discovery or revelation of hidden truths or imposters that are exposed, which can generate a new beginning, it is the new beginning that you could be really involved with, Leo, and that could be quite exciting for you. Just make sure it's not a new beginning that has anything to do with evil or with some sort of attack, because if that happens to anybody, they have to use speed and technology to surmount that or get beyond it, and you might have to do that, Leo. So if there is some little problem coming up, quite surprisingly, you will have to act fast to remedy it. But on the other hand, if there is a new start, it could really be headed straight towards you, Leo. And I think that you could be excited by that. So good luck. Okay, what does it mean to a Virgo? Well, Virgo, just like Gemini, you need to be very, very careful. The solar eclipse with four planets in Pisces, the Sun, Moon, Mercury, your own ruler, and Neptune are all opposing your sun sign, and Saturn in Sagittarius is squaring your sun sign. And that simply means that you would have to work really hard, and you would have to expect delays and encounter some challenges. I think you've been doing that for a while, but the real danger is from enlightenment. And you sadly need that, Virgo, because I can guarantee you somebody has been telling you exactly what you want to hear, and it's a lie. Or you do not know what else they're doing. But somebody is really painting a lot of blue sky for you right now, Virgo. And my advice to you is that you need to really look at all their promises and their rosy projections for the future and all the goodwill they're spreading around right now. And you need to examine that by factual information to see if it's really true. So try not to make any serious commitment right now, Virgo. You would probably live to regret it, because there are too many planets in Pisces opposing your sun sign, and Pisces can rule hidden enemies and deceptions and omissions. So there's somebody around that's not telling you the whole truth, and they're sure not telling you what else they're doing in their life. And so you need to make a calendar or a diary or some sort of journal, and just date everything for the next 6 months, and list your observances or the promises that are made to you. And 6 months from now, when there's another solar eclipse, check it out and see if everything adds up. Because I'm pretty sure somebody is painting a lot of blue sky, and if you fall for it, you will really regret it, Virgo. So try not to make any serious commitment. If you're serious about something, it can wait 6 months before you find out if it's really all true or not. Okay, what does it mean to a Libra? Well, Libra, Jupiter is the only retrograde planet right now, and it is in your sign, and it's also the only planet in an air sign. And so this is a time when you can be facing challenges, but particularly from the planets that are in front of the solar eclipse, the three that are in Aries, Uranus, Venus, your own ruler, and Mars, because it's the Mars and Uranus that are exactly conjuncting each other and very forceful at the moment. And so you can be on the verge of some sort of legal problem or some sort of split in a partnership or a separation or even a divorce. Or it can involve a business problem, because Pluto in Capricorn is squaring your sun. So you have to be a little bit careful right now of what steps you take, Libra. And I would say before you take them, think defensively about everything. The planets in Aries that are opposing your sun sign are really powerful right now. And two of them, Uranus and Mars, are up to no good. And therefore, you need to really watch everything around you and look for danger and be aware of the possibility of any sudden attack, because it could come right at you, Libra, particularly since you're such a peaceful person. You could be in the wrong place at the wrong time and be hurt by that. Remember, you'd have to react with speed and technology, and everyone would have to do that. So this is a time to be very careful about what you're doing and be on the alert for danger. Okay, what does it mean to a Scorpio? Well, Scorpio, this solar eclipse in Pisces with four planets there is very good for you because it means you will benefit from any revelations that come about behind the scenes right now, because there's so much light in Pisces. So the Sun, Moon, Mercury, and Neptune are all trining your sun, and that can be a tremendous benefit to you, Scorpio, because your sign rules justice and survival. And in order to endure justice and to survive something, you have to be able to look at the whole truth about something. And that is what you'll see now, Scorpio. So if you've been trying to hide anything, it's going to come out in the open, and you'll have to face it. But remember that enlightenment can free us from being a prisoner in our past. And so the truth will set you free, Scorpio, and that will be good. It will also set you free if you are learning sort of the ugly truth about somebody else. And then you will know exactly how to handle that. There's also the possibility that there could have been some money kept from you or hidden. And if you learn about that, you could benefit from that as well. So good luck. And this is a healing solar eclipse for you, which is good. Okay, what does it mean to a Sagittarian? Well, Sagittarius, you are in a unique position. And that is because you could try to challenge people right now, because Saturn in your sign is squaring the four planets in Pisces under the solar eclipse. So you could cause delay if you wanted to, or you could simply be very strict about rules and regulations. But maybe that is according to your values. Maybe that's real important to you. Or you could be really on a treadmill right now and zooming toward a new beginning. And that is because Mars and Uranus are exactly conjunct in Aries, and Venus is there as well, and they are trining your Sun and Saturn there. So either you can be somebody who wants to stall and provide delaying tactics, or you can be somebody that's caught up in a new beginning for one reason or another. I hope you can meet a middle ground, Sagittarius. A middle ground would be better than going too quickly or being obstructive. So I hope that you weigh your choices carefully. And when in doubt, step back right now, because you yourself are not as strong as you think you are. And if you're worried about something, I would say just be real careful about it and go slow. Okay, what does it mean to a Capricorn? Well, Capricorn, the Pisces solar eclipse on Sunday sextiles your Sun, which can present many opportunities for enlightenment for you and for healing. And so it's when we face the truth and hidden facts are revealed, or imposters are exposed, that is when we can do something about that, and enlightenment can free you from your past problems. And that means you can get over things and heal up, and then listen to the call of the future, which is what you should be doing, Capricorn. We can't live in the past, and we can't keep everything the same. There are seven planets in just two signs. And so when they start moving, everything's going to start moving. And that is why you should take advantage of a sort of a quiet time for you to examine the hidden truth that is in your heart. And that is because with enlightenment, you can have hope and truth, and you can be able to listen to the call of the future. And that's what you need to do. Concentrate on the future. Don't stay stuck in some sort of vice right now of misinformation. And it could be that you're kidding yourself about something, or that you have been kidding yourself, but now is the time to turn around and face it and be free from it. So good luck. Okay, what does it mean to an Aquarian? Well, Aquarius, remember there are no planets in any of the fixed signs right now, and yet that solar eclipse is right ahead of your Sun sign with four planets in Pisces, and right ahead of them are three planets in Aries. And so, Aquarius, I think that you are about to sort of be on a roll, but it will take enlightenment for you to decide which path to take in your life. Your sign does rule the future. So yes, you are going into the future, Aquarius. There's no doubt about that. But your ruler, Uranus, is exactly conjunct Mars in Aries, and those can be two malefic planets, particularly with Mars involved. And so you need to not act too quickly right now, Aquarius, because there isn't anything big stopping you, but you could take a sudden wrong turn if you do act too quickly, and that could be prompted by other people that want to push you into something right now. So if I were you, I'd be very, very careful, because let the truth come out and be enlightened first before you decide which direction you want to go in. Okay, what does it mean to a Pisces? Well, Pisces, this solar eclipse was just meant for you. It's far better than last year's solar eclipse, because it isn't being as challenged as last year's was. And so there's only one planet squaring your Sun sign, and that is Saturn in Sagittarius. But on Sunday, you'll have the Sun, Moon, Mercury, and your own ruler, Neptune, in your sign. And that simply means that, yes, you'll have to obey strict rules and regulations, and you may have to face some delays. But if you want to make a dream come true, Pisces, now is the time to do it. And you can do that by examining what you have in your heart, the truth in your heart, and you can be admitting past mistakes, and that can free you from the past and enable you to make a new beginning, which you are definitely going to do, Pisces. And that's because those three planets in Aries are really supercharged right now, and Aries rules new beginnings. But it begins with charity and understanding and the truth about yourself and perhaps about some things that you have gotten over and that you are willing to admit so that you can go on and listen to the call of the future. That's the direction you're going in, Pisces, so I wish you the best of luck. Okay, you can see this show by subscribing to it on our website if you like, and that is starborninstitute.org. Bye.